mga saw-saw kayo. Kaya ikaw, George Briones, magpaliwanag ka sa alumni, ha? Bakit mo ako tinawag na narcissistic, ha? Narcissist mo ako. Sige, Mr. Esguera, next question.
Okay, have you ever gotten in touch with Commissioner Ferolino? After this, no. Nagkausap na ba kayo o hindi pa rin?
The last text na was 24. So I told Commissioner Cascale, why don't you be the one to call her? You tell her if she cannot do it, she can waive it. And you can take it over even if I know you're also very busy. But at least we have an assurance that it will be released before my retirement. Okay. But she did not reply to to Commissioner Cascale. So in executive session, I told the chair and the commissioners my problem. And so I asked the chair that he should be the one to call Commissioner Ferolino and perhaps she will answer. Yeah. Instead, she issues a memorandum explaining her delay at the same time attacking me for wanting publicity. Ayun na naman, may Commissioner Ferolino, sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan eh. Sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan, hindi ko na kailangan ng publicity. Gusto okay. ko lang, mag-retire ako with honor, integrity, and excellence. Okay. Hindi yung pinababoy nyo yung presiding commissioner nyo. What, you are disrespecting me? You have no respect for me as your senior commissioner and presiding commissioner. Okay. If I had more than 5 days to be in COMELEC, I'm really going to make you account for this discourtesy. She's okay. already...
Commissioner.
Ferolino makes it appear that she is the victim here. No. Okay. The people are the victim here.
Okay, you made that clear, no? Pero given this...
vote can be counted.
Okay, given this back and forth...
Too, so that my vote will be counted.
Okay. You made that clear, no? So... Given this back and forth between you and Commissioner Ferolino, how do you think this could affect whatever decision would ultimately come out? Kasi baka naman magkaroon talaga ng duda.
Whatever the outcome is. Whatever decision will come out will go up anyway on motion for reconsideration. And then will go up anyway to Supreme Court. I keep on telling all these Marcos loyalists, you know. It is to your benefit na. It's in everybody's benefit and interest that this case goes up to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. Why? What if Bongbong Marcos is DQ'd by the Supreme Court, you know, 1 week before elections? Who will he substitute? How will he substitute campaign? What if he is DQ'd by the Supreme Court after the elections and he has not substituted?
Okay.
He will not be able to assume office. What if he wins but he was DQ'd? He will be removed from office. That is why it is better that this case goes to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. It is in the nation's interest. Why are you holding your resolution there as if that is the final?
Let's go to your basis, the arguments or the basis that you cited in your opinion to disqualify Bongbong Marcos. Sabi niyo maliwanag, it's a crime that involved moral turpitude. But others were claiming na it's very difficult to determine whether that particular crime, done filing of ITR for 4 years, constituted a crime of involving moral turpitude. How did you arrive at that?
Let the Supreme Court decide this so that I will know if I am right or wrong. Huh? How can you be more scholarly than I am? Can you claim to be smarter than I am in the law and jurisprudence? No lawyer here except justices of the Supreme Court can claim that they can read the law better than me. Oh, by golly. Let's have a debate on national TV. Even Briones already backed out because he does not meet the height requirement.
Okay. So, how did you determine that, yung moral turpitude, when others were claiming na hindi raw siya ganun kaliwanag?
Tell me. Very simple things. Way. Simple lang na tao dyan, no? Tricycle driver, tanungin mo. Yung... matanda na sabi nila nagnakaw ng 10 kilong mangga, kinulong nila. Moral turpitude pag nanakaw. Sa Australia, traffic violation, moral turpitude. They will cancel your application for citizenship. Moral turpitude. Traffic violation lang ha. Nag one-way street ka lang. Dito sa Pilipinas, ibig mo sabihin, hindi ka nag-file ng income tax return? Apat na beses bilang gobernador ng Ilocos at ang presidente ay, at diktador ay ama mo? Hindi pa yun moral turpitude. Tanungin mo batang maliit na magaling ng pagpalaki na magulang, good ba yan na ako bad? Ay bad yan, hindi siya nagbayad eh. Utang yan sa gobyerno eh. And he was convicted. Convicted! Marcos Jr. is convicted. He's a convict. How many times do I have to say that? That he's a convict? He was convicted twice in the regional trial court and in the court of appeals. But he did not pay the fine. He did not even bother to pay the fine. So how am I supposed to help him, even if he's the brother of my seatmate, Jaime Marcos? How can I help him in some way when that is everything that he did is on record, admitted by his lawyers? I cannot find any legal justification for his actions. I cannot conclude but say that all of those failure to file income tax returns for 4 years and failure to fine, to pay the fine in regional trial court were intentional. Were intentionally done with a cavalier attitude, being the son of the president who thought that he was above the law.
So you made that very clear, which reminds me when we interviewed the attorney Briones before, he was very somehow cavalier about it as well. Ang claim niya, in the non-payment of, non-filing of ITRs for 4 years, wala rin pinagkaiba. It's as simple as jaywalking. So that was her attitude at that time. Jaywalking lang daw. Parang jaywalking lang daw yan.
Nagnakaw nga ang tao, 10 kilong mangga ay kinulong nila. Ito, bali, pag nanakaw din ito ng buwis sa gobyerno 4 taon, hindi nagbayad ng multa, hindi ito moral turpitude. Ay, pambihira naman. Ano bang reasonable ni standard lang po ito, attorney. Summary po si summary. Summary lang ang COMELEC. Hindi po kami criminal case na beyond reasonable doubt ang standard. Substantial evidence lang po. Pambira naman kayo. Kasi hindi naman kayo nagpa-practice sa COMELEC eh. Never naman kayo nag-appear dyan sa amin. So, hirap naman na nagpapanggap kayong expert-expert kayo. Wala naman kayong alam sa election law. Estudyante ko kayo, ilang beses na kayo na 5 isang araw.
Okay, and that note.
Tumigil na natin, Attorney Briones. You let Attorney Rodriguez speak for his client. Sausaw itong partido mo na di naman kayo kasali. Contempt na kita pag nainis ako sa'yo eh. Bukas, contempt na kita.
Okay, and that note, thank you very much, Commissioner Rowena Aguanzon, for joining us tonight. Good luck on your retirement on February 2.
Alam nyo, kawawa lang si George Briones eh. Sinalang nyo lang dito para may diversionary tactic eh, which is very bad. I can see what you are doing. Let's focus on the question of Commissioner Ferolino, when are you going to release your ponensya resolution?
Yeah, actually, nasagot nyo na po yan. So
release it before February 2 so that I can attach my vote and separate opinion.
Yeah.
If you do not do so, you may be liable under Section 3C. Of the Anti-Graft on Corruption and Corrupt Practices Act, which may be an impeachable offense.
Okay.
Thank you very much, mga kababayan.
Thank you for making that clear. Thank you for joining us tonight, Commissioner Guanzon.
Thank you very much.